Hi, my name's David. That's my tank. That's my new scape. And I'm going to show you guys how I put it together. Let's do this. G'day everyone, my name is David Meyer. Welcome back to First Time Reefer TV. And my friends, has it been a long time? I've been dealing with so much crap at work at the moment, and our family's been pretty crazy, so I haven't been a little bit slack. So firstly, I'll apologize. Secondly, I think I'm gonna try and stick to weekly videos every Sunday at this stage. I'm not sure what time yet, but I'll make sure I don't clash with the two gay reefers, because I don't want you to pick friends, you know? Let's not have favorites. So the tank has been kicking along really, really well. It has been going through its ugly stage, so I have sort of just left it. I have got a couple of new things in there, such as an auto feeder, so it can be on autopilot. Everything inside the cabinet is working fantastic. As you can see, can you see that there? Let's check this. I've got some lights. Pax Bellum is in, but not hooked up yet. The new GW7 Plus DC skimmer is in there. The PacSun's Core 7 is in there. KH Lab not running yet, but it will be soon. Got a couple of other new toys for this tank too, but it has been going really, really well. I'm loving the Cade tank, and I must say it is definitely such a significant upgrade from their previous models. So well done to the team at Cade there, and Mr. Adam Dalton. So we are gonna get this scape now into our tank. You know, I've done a little bit of a video on scaping before, but we'll quickly just reiterate the facts. Firstly, decide which material you're going to use. Heaps of artificial rock available on the market these days, but good old live rock is still really good as well. That'll sort of dictate what type of scape you can get or what type of scape design you can do. Because obviously with live rock, you're gonna work pretty quickly and pretty irregular shapes. Whereas with dry rock, you can take your time piecing it together and actually scape your design. So in this case, I've stuck with my original Carib Sea Life Rock, which was in there. I've added a piece of shapes, and some of this beautiful, magnificent branching rock from Real Reef Rock. Now, yes, it is not cheap, but the style of scape you can get is exactly what I was after. It looks really beautiful, nice fingers branching out, nice open spaces for coral. And I couldn't go faster as soon as I saw that down at Reef Galleria at Billy's shop. So that comes to the next step. You know, once you decide on what material you're going to use and what rock you want to use and the style of scape you're going to go, you've got to make sure you allow enough room for corals to grow into. There's nothing worse than rock too close to each other, where as soon as the coral starts growing, it's actually just going to fill up the whole spot and have nowhere to go. So make sure there's plenty of open space for the coral to grow into, which allows for heaps of space and area for flow to get around the coral. Now, flow is pretty critical to make sure there are no dead spots inside your tank where detritus can build up, but it also allows for flow to get around the coral. So make sure that they're nice and healthy. Now, I measured this out on the table that I built it on over there, just to make sure that I'm also leaving enough room from the sides of the tank. So, coral aren't gonna touch the glass when they grow, fish aren't gonna get stuck, and most importantly, my little flipper blade can get past any of the branches without smashing into it and leaving this annoying little spot that you can't get to with a flipper blade. Now, a couple of different styles that I tried with this scape. For the first time, I got one of these bottles from D-Mac. He had one spare and he told me to try it out, which is essentially an accelerator for super glue. It is called Foam Safe Kicker. Hopefully you can zoom in on that. Nah, not quite. And then I also used Aquaforest Gel Fix. So this is the super glue gel. This is the accelerator. You essentially have your two rocks together, squeeze the gel in, spray this on there, blow it off, and boom, silicon sets very, very quickly. Now, you can't use this on coral, unfortunately, because I think that does no good for the coral at all. So that is one method, and I'll go through the method that I use specifically. This product here is called Aqua Need It. This is just from Bunnings, which is something that I've used previously before. It's basically a two-part polymer, I think it's called. Yeah, polymer compound. So essentially you've got one agent on the outside, one on the inside, snip off exactly how much you want, roll it up as much as you can with gloves on, because that was stuck to my hand for so long. With gloves on until everything is together, then essentially you got a bit of time to, you know, all of these joints here have used that. So, you know, between the two rocks, you just join it together and press the pot compound around it. I think I saw Shane did a video where you can actually put it on each end of the parts that you're sticking together, then put it together and meld it, which I thought was pretty smart as well. But in this case scenario, I had all these held up with different bottles and different structures, and then literally just molded it around the end of the branches there to hold it in place. And I left that for 24 hours to make sure it cured nice and strong. Now, there are aquarium specific products as well, but the Aquanita has worked really well for me in the past, so I didn't see any point of trying anything else. And I think it was about 18 bucks or something from Bunnings. Now, probably one of the best products that'll give you the strongest hold on the market is Aquaforest. Man, I'm trying to make a video. Chill out, you know? Sorry. Aquaforest Stone Fix. This is basically a cement which you mix in with water. Make sure you don't put too much water because this can get very, very liquid. So essentially, after I did the super glue to hold it in place and then use the Aqua Need It to actually give it a firm hold, I use this to really cake it on and over the join, and also to cover all the white from the Aqua Need It. And this gives it a super, super strong hold because it's literally cement. This is probably the best product on the market to put your scape together. It can be just a little bit liquid, so just make sure when you mix it together, use less is better, because you can always add liquid, but then you can also add product as well. So essentially, I just caked it over the top of the Aqua Need It that I used. Now you can see with my scape, that is one piece there with all the branches, and this is the second piece, which I haven't exactly decided how I'm gonna put in. I've been tossing out between an arch like that and leaving it nice and open underneath. Getting it like that, but I can decide that once it's in the tank. So we're gonna remove all this now, get the scape in there. Those two pieces of rocks with the coral on there, I am gonna keep in there for now until I decide exactly what I'm gonna do. But yeah, when it comes to scaping, just make sure you have those factors in mind, and also making sure the structure is super solid so it doesn't break down, because there's nothing worse than having it full of coral and having the scape break apart. But yeah, let's get it inside the tank. Now, I'm going to turn the skimmer off before I get this new rock in there, because some of this can send your skimmer nuts, because especially the carob sea, it's sprayed with the bacteria, which makes your skimmer go off tap. So I'll turn off the skimmer, leave the flow running. I'm gonna get all of this out onto the table or into some buckets or something like that. I like to do it. So we got our structure. Hopefully I've measured it correctly and it's gonna fit, but it is pretty heavy. So that's escape inside the tank now. I think I'm gonna have to get rid of some of the original rocks that I had in there, just to open up that space to really highlight this. So yeah, remember all those things that I said when you're designing a scape. I'm gonna get the tank running now, change the filter floss over, hopefully get everything a little bit cleaner, and we'll come back in our next video and check out how the tank's doing. Thanks for watching today, guys. If you like and learnt anything today, please subscribe to the channel. And until next time, my friends, peace out.